Your table is waiting.
You are the big dog in this family, Dr. Hansen. He looks to you for leadership.
Where is he from? I've only been seeing him for a couple of weeks. I don't know his whole life history.
I've never been here before. What's it called?
My backyard.
Wake up, darling. Time to go.
Where?
To John's house for Thanksgiving. Come, the limo's waiting.
Wow, they sent a limo? Mm.
This ain't the Hansons, dear. It's the big time.
Oh.
Quickly, darling, let's not be late. Come, come, Sid, we're here.
This is how the other half lives.
There she is, the family matriarch.
Welcome, welcome.
Get a load of the diamonds.
I'm Mrs. Hemming. This is my mother, Linda.
So nice to finally meet.
It certainly is. You know, I've just been dying to chat. I'd love to hear how a girl from such obvious good stock managed to find herself in a family clinic.
Her father's influence, I'm afraid.
Shall we go in? I'm so delighted you could come. Let me see to your coat. James?
Oh, so sorry, Mrs. Hemming. I was dealing with some other guests.
Mom?
What? Oh, sorry. We won't be dining till 3. Perhaps you care for some hors d'oeuvres.
Anything with caviar?
Everything with caviar, darling. Mm-hmm.
Joni, what are you doing here? I don't know, but I've been in the kitchen since 5, spreading fish eggs on mini toast. Hey, maybe you could help me get a coffee break, or at least the minimum wage.
Oh, miss.
Champagne?
Waiter.
You rang for bubbly?
Mother? Why is our entire family working for the Hemmings?
Oh, that. I was hoping you wouldn't notice. It's a bit complicated. Can it wait till after dessert?
No.
Well, if you must know, this is a bump up in class, and our family wasn't quite good enough. You and I are the only ones that made the cut.
Let's not be premature, Linda. You are definitely in, but we'll have to see how Sid does during dinner.
But this is a test?
No, dear. It's a dry run.
Oh, sorry, Sid. That's just the way it is in our family.
You might never get another shot at this kind of family for the rest of your life.
Stomach just tried to leave the building.
Well, is it coming in waves or is it continuous?
Ugh, a wave. One you could surf.
Yeah, you probably have that stomach flu that's going around. I've got some Compazine. There's 2 pills left. That should make you feel better in a couple hours.
Last thing I want to do is spend Thanksgiving dinner at the Ridley's trapped in the bathroom.
No. Please.
So you're definitely going to Bird's?
I think so. You're going to John's?
We've talked about it, but I wanted to wait and see what the family was doing before I said yes. No coffee?
We ran out. Thanksgiving with the filthy rich. Is that like a black tie situation?
They seem like normal people. We're out of coffee.
Oh, bummer.
Hey, Robbie, you got any plans for Thanksgiving?
Yeah, work. Mr. O'Neill thinks it's a gold mine waiting to happen. Why?
I'm going to Bert's. Sid's going to John's, so if you're booked, that officially means no Thanksgiving at the Hanson household. What about Dad? What's he doing?
I don't know, but he can always come by O'Neill's. See you later.
Well, I gotta run. Are you all done?
Yeah, all done.
Hey, take those pills. Yes, doctor.
Morning, Tommy.
Hey, Robbie.
Hey, Reg, what you got cooking?
There's a lunch omelet. Care to join me?
I think I'll pass. Do you have the lunch specials ready?
Yeah, put them on the bar.
Thanks, sir.
I hate to trouble you, brother, but as you can see, I've lost my way, and I deeply appreciate a meal.
Sure. Just wait right here. Hey, Reggie. Changed my mind about that omelet.
Ah, smell got you, huh? All right, give me 2 minutes.
Thanks.
I'm Ed Keller. I'm with the Kingman Brothers Circus.
Oh.
Hi, I'm Dr. Hansen. How can I help you?
Danny here's been with us for about 3 months.
We got him from another circus that went under.
We were hoping to train him to make him one of our new acts, but he's not responding. We thought he might be ailing.
Really? How's that?
Well, after a meal, he seems to want more food, but when we give it to him, he doesn't eat it. Also, he touches his forehead like he's got a headache or something.
Is it all right if I keep him overnight?
He's all yours, Doc.
Danny, you go with Heather, Danny.
Thanks, Doc.
Don't you go anywhere, Jim Hansen.
Cynthia.
I had a dream about you last night.
Oh.
You were so naughty, I almost ran right over here to fill you in on all the deliciously sordid details.
Fortunately, I don't have the time right now.
Of course, I wouldn't do that in mixed company. You know how sensitive Kobe is about my affections.
Oh, I seem to remember that, yes. Kobe, nice to see you.
Jimmy, I need to talk to you about one other matter. For the first time in years, I am hosting Thanksgiving, and I am hoping my gym boy can come.
Oh.
I promise you the food will be absolutely spectacular, and I'm even making Kobe his own little hen. I will expect you 3-ish Thursday. Good.
What'd she say?
I don't know. Let's get her cleaned up and get her to CT. They're waiting for us.
Excuse me.
Do you work here?
Yeah. I run a bar called O'Neill's. A guy came by this morning looking for a meal. He was about 5'10", medium build, sunken eyes. Anybody here fit that description?
Only about 80 or 90 men.
Yeah.
You all right, man? Yeah, I see. Ah, nothing broken. Let's get you up.
I believe you have something that belongs to me.
What's that?
What, my wallet?
Why would you think I have your wallet?
Because it was on the bar when you came in, and then 2 minutes later it was gone.
I was gone myself. The cops pulled up, said move on, I moved on. I swear.
Yeah, so why'd you run?
Because you were chasing me.
I guess I owe you an apology.
Don't worry about it.
Well, look, if you ever need a meal or...
Forget about it.
See, piercings are more political than tattoos. And they're way easier to accessorize.
Well, it is all about accessories.
Yeah. Oh. Whoa. Are you okay?
Just a little nauseous.
My sister was the same way her first couple of months. Couldn't keep anything down. Her husband called her the exorcist.
I'm not pregnant, Megan.
Are you sure? Because I have kind of a vibe about these things. I mean, it's totally extraterrestrial.
Trust me, I know my own body. Huh. There. See? I'm fine.
Tommy, have you seen my wallet?
Yeah, I put it in the office. Bad habit, Robbie, leaving it out like that. Somebody could come by and pick it up. What happened to your eye?
I did something stupid.
She's good. They're gonna keep her here for observation. She has a slight concussion.
Nice save from what I hear.
Well, I was at the right place at the right time.
There's an old Chinese proverb. No such thing as coincidence. I studied herbal medicine in Shanghai for a couple of months.
What haven't you done?
I've never invited a woman to my parents' place for Thanksgiving. So, we on?
I'd love to come. Hello.
Oh, hi, Bert. The usual, living la vida, Joni. Tonight, I can't get a babysitter, and Sid's at the hospital. Hannah is crying. I gotta go. Sure, tomorrow. 10 o'clock coffee. Great. Okay.
Hey, has anybody reported her missing?
Oh, that's too bad.
Okay. All right, then I'll see you there. All right, bye-bye. How you feeling? Did you try those pills I gave you?
I did. Oh, I feel so much better. Thanks.
And I'm glad they helped. All right, I'll see you later.
Bye.
Danny, how are you doing this morning? Hmm? Yeah. Here we go.
You hungry?
What's he doing?
I'm not sure. I think that was a gesture Mr. Keller said was about a headache.
Do chimps have headaches?
I suppose it's possible. We get the lab results yet?
Yeah, they all came back negative.
Oh, well, that's good. How's he eating?
polished off 3 bananas for breakfast. He acted like he wanted more, but he wouldn't eat.
Oh?
He was doing this thing with his hand on his mouth.
Yeah, he was doing the same thing for me just before you came in. Why don't you call Mr. Keller, see if he'll come back over here. Maybe he can tell us something useful.
Okay.
Hey, Rich, I got a takeout order for lunch today.
All right. Throw it at me, Rob.
We need 10 assorted sandwich trays, 8 fruit plates, and a dozen platters of French fries.
A dozen fries.
Hey, Dr. Hanson.
How's the little girl doing?
CT scan's normal, no skull fracture, no C-spine injury. Her neuro exam is fine. My only concern, though, is her decreased potassium.
Will you be releasing her today?
Well, if her repeat labs come back within normal range, yeah, she's free to go home.
Assuming she had a home.
Sorry, we just patch him up.
Yeah. Hello? Sid.
My name Enchi.
Hello, Enchi. Where are you going?
Look for parents.
Do you know where they are?
Excuse me.
Oh, it's you again. I hope you're not here to chase away any of my guys.
No, I'm sorry about that. It was a mistake. I actually brought some food. It's in the car. Listen, you haven't seen,
Dwayne? Yeah, he's probably down by the Water Place Bridge. He likes to play his guitar down there.
Thanks a lot.
You know, I've been thinking, we're both so busy, it's hard to get that really sustained quality time.
Boy, is it.
So I'm thinking maybe we should get away sometime, just the two of us.
That would be nice.
How about June?
June?
Well, the 14th to the 21st, to be exact. My buddy rented this place in Stowe for 2 weeks, and he can only use the first one, so we could have the other week all to ourselves.
Wow, that sounds great.
So should I go ahead and book it?
Well, I don't know. I have to check first. That's like, what, 7 months away.
So?
So, 7 months is a long time. A lot can happen between now and then.
Like what?
I don't know. I didn't have anything particular in mind. It's just a saying.
Well, let me know by Thursday, can you?
Thursday?
Well, yeah, he wants to offer the place to his sister and her husband if we're not going to take it, so.
Sure.
Okay, well, good. You can tell me when you come over for dinner. My parents are very excited to meet you.
Sorry about the mix-up yesterday.
Promises were made, any words were left unsaid.
I brought some food for the guys. It's back at the shelter, so if you want to eat.
I'm not really hungry right now.
You know, now and then we book musicians at the bar. I mean, it pays not much, but food and drinks are on the house.
Do us both a favor. Skip the social work.
But you're not interested in the job?
Under the circumstances, I'd only let you down.
Okay, well, think about it. You don't have to give me an answer now.
All right.
It's a great tune, by the way.
right this way.
Delighted we can finally have a chance to sit down and talk.
Me too. I'm so sorry for canceling yesterday.
Oh, that's quite all right.
Thank you.
John told me about that poor little Chinese girl. How is she?
She's gonna be fine.
Sid, would you care for some wine?
Oh, no, thank you. I have to go back to work after lunch.
Your generation is so conscientious. In my day, it would be absolutely nothing to be soused at noon.
Mother?
I'm not going to apologize for my generation. John tells me that you're a very talented plastic surgeon, but that you're not practicing.
Oh, no, I still practice. But my main focus has been running a clinic for the past 2 years.
Sid is wonderful with people. They really respond to her.
He's smitten with you, if you haven't noticed. And from where I'm sitting, it looks like the feeling is mutual.
That's a cute little bear, Angie. What's his name?
Hello there.
I see you've made a friend.
I guess so. Hi, Angie.
Well, unfortunately, we have to take her down to social services. Maybe you could help us out.
This is my good friend, Alex. You don't have to be afraid of him. He's just trying to help you.
He find parents?
No, not yet.
So why don't you get your things, sweetheart, and you come with me, okay?
No, I want to stay with Sid.
I could take her for a few days.
Well, I think we could arrange something. But we still need to take her down to the office for processing.
All right, Angie, how would you like to go to my house?
Your house?
Yeah, it'd be lots of fun. My dad is an animal doctor, and my sister has a little girl that you could play with.
Okay.
Oh, good. So it's all settled. I'm gonna go with you to Alex's office, and then I'll come back and pick you up later.
Okay.
Good.
Thanks, Sid.
Dr. Hans, Mr. Keller's here.
Oh, hi. Thanks for coming back.
Oh, no problem. How's Danny?
Well, I've been doing some tests. He seems in good health.
Great.
But to be honest, I'm concerned that the situation may not be technically medical.
What do you mean?
Are you his primary handler?
That's Jack Denson. Why?
Is there any possibility that Mr. Denson is abusive to Danny?
I've known the man 20 years and never met a nicer guy. I mean, he calls here every day just to check on him.
Well, that notwithstanding, there's more here than meets the eye. One more thing, that gesture Danny makes on his head, how long has he been doing that?
Since the first day we got him.
Hey.
Hey. So we still on for dinner?
Oh, there's been a change in plan. I'm taking Angie home with me.
For the night?
For the week. At least until they find her parents.
What about social services? I mean, shouldn't they be taking over at this point?
They have to process her, which they're doing now, and then I'm going back to pick her up.
That's really sweet of you.
She was so terrified, I just couldn't let them put her in a halfway house.
Does this mean that you won't be coming over for Thanksgiving?
Well, I don't know. Let's just see how it goes. Maybe I could bring her with me.
You know, my mother loves you. I mean, she can't stop talking about your natural grace, elegance.
She seems very nice.
Appearances are deceiving. Underneath those pearls, she is one tough mother.
Well, I'd put her up against my mom any day.
They say that you can tell how a woman will turn out by meeting her maker.
Believe me, if you'd met Linda, we wouldn't be talking right now. Thank you. What a good girl. Hey, we're home.
Hi there. You must be Anchi. Welcome.
Anchi, that's my dad. And there's Joni, and that's Hannah.
Hi, Anchi. Hannah, can you say hi to Aunt Chi?
No.
Okay.
We're just about to have dinner. Do you like spaghetti?
Spaghetti?
Long Italian noodles.
I like noodles very much.
I put sheets on the pullout upstairs so you can bunk with Hannah.
Oh, great.
Why don't we go to the refrigerator and see if Aunt Chi wants something to drink? Aunt Chi, are you thirsty?
I'm gonna run upstairs and wash up.
Dinner's just about ready.
How did she do last night?
Great. I heard them both giggling until midnight.
How you doing?
Good. Good, that compazine saved my life. Any word on Angie's parents?
No. No one's even put out a missing persons report on her yet.
Yeah. Be such a wreck. You know, I worry about Hannah all the time. You know, is she okay? Is she feeling safe? When is she gonna start hating me?
You're doing a terrific job with her, Johnny.
Ugh. That's all I can do to balance her in a job, not to mention a personal life. There's only one of her.
Yeah, well, there's one of me, one of Dad, and even one of Robbie. You do have a support system.
There's only so much support you can expect, even from your own family.
Sit. Got a delivery.
What is it?
No, no. You want this closer to the couch or over by the fireplace?
What is it?
It's a 12-lead supercharged electrocardiogram machine. This baby will let you know if you got a heart problem, then tell you where it is. It's kind of like LoJack.
I didn't order this.
I brought it over to the clinic, but they needed you to sign for it. Says here it's from the Hemming Foundation. Use it in good health. Good health, get it?
Yeah, I get it.
They must really like you. This is the Eldorado of EKGs. Runs you up around 10-11 Lodge. Sign here, please.
Morning, Heather.
Morning.
How's our star primate? Still eating well?
Another 3-banana breakfast. Hmm. And he was really thirsty this morning. He asked for a second bottle of water.
He asked?
Well, he kept doing this.
Really? Is that the exact gesture he made?
Yeah, why?
Well, there's some pretty well-documented studies of primates using sign language.
Do you think Danny can sign?
I don't know, but it might explain this thing he does on his head.
Well, how can we find out?
Why don't you run down to the bookstore and see if you can pick up a signing dictionary, and let's check it out.
Okay.
Great timing. My special's almost ready. Want something? Something to drink?
Nah, brought my own.
Wow, it's a beauty. Is that antique?
That's all I'm told.
Oh, no thanks. Thought about my offer?
Look, it's real generous and everything, but... Well, for starters, I don't have any clothes.
That's all right. Borrow some of my stuff. We're about the same size.
All right, there's another thing. I can't play without my guitar. It's over in a pawn shop on Flower Street.
What about the one you were playing at the shelter?
Ah, it's not mine. It's just a piece of junk one of the boys picked up.
I'll tell you what. Come on in, and after lunch, we'll go buy it back. You could give me half your salary every night until we're even.
Got yourself a bad deal.
All right.
Hey.
Hey, what a nice surprise.
I have some good news. I think I found somebody who might help us locate Angie's parents.
Who?
Well, his name's Simon Chan. He's a private investigator, and he works in the Asian community.
Boy, the Hemming family doesn't fool around.
What?
You don't know? Your mother sent me an EKG machine for the clinic.
Really?
The note said it was from the Family Foundation, but her fingerprints were all over it.
She likes to consider herself kind of a stealth philanthropist.
So you had nothing to do with this?
No.
Uh-huh. So when do we see this investigator?
I made us an appointment for tomorrow morning. I figured I'd come by, pick you up, we could go have some breakfast, and then head on over.
Well, you think of everything, don't you?
I try.
So
Can I help you guys?
Yeah, we're interested in the guitar.
$800.
You only gave me $500.
That's what we call a profit, pal. Now, you want it or not?
Wayne, I don't have that kind of money.
What am I supposed to play?
We'll have to rent a guitar. If you really want it back, you have to put it on some kind of installment plan.
If it's still here.
Look, this is my home phone, and this is my cell. If you get a potential buyer, would you please call me first?
Well, I'll do what I can, but I'm not promising anything.
Thank you.
How are we gonna start?
Well, I guess we'll begin with the basics. Hi.
Oh, my God. He said hi back.
Yeah, what do you know?
Maybe you should introduce yourself.
Sure. My name is Jim. My name is Rocket? Your name is Rocket?
Hi, Rocket. Now what's he saying?
I don't know. I feel sick. Please help me.
Thanksgiving was celebrated less than a year after the pilgrims first arrived on the new land.
Pilgrims?
Yeah, those are the people who came here from England. They had a really long, hard journey.
They come by boat?
Yeah, they did. Just like you. Here. Here's China. And here's the United States. And look right there. That's Providence. See, Providence got its name because the man who found it thought that God had brought him here.
God bring me here?
I suppose he did.
Parents, too?
Yep.
God lose parents.
No, honey, I don't think so. If we're lucky, we're gonna find them by Thanksgiving.
I'm lucky to find you.
No, I'm the lucky one. Got a second?
Sure, come on in. Just cleaning out some stuff I haven't worn since high school. My like a virgin phase. Ugh, thank God that was a quickie.
Are you okay?
Yeah, why?
You're reorganizing your closet.
So?
You only do that when something's really bothering you. Remember when Mom died? You redid mine and yours.
What's your point, Sid? You think something's really bothering me?
Yeah. I think you're pregnant.
Pregnant?
You've been nauseous, you stopped drinking caffeine, and you lied to me about taking the composine. I found the sample box. So you really are?
Hey, it happens.
It doesn't have to happen.
That's right. Tell me how it's all my fault, just like everything else.
No, I'm just trying to...
What, lecture me? It's a little late for that, Sid. I already flunked the how not to become an unwed mother test. If you were really concerned about me, you'd stop making me feel like the family idiot and help me figure out what the hell I'm supposed to do now.
Good morning, Rocket. Would you like some bananas for breakfast? No? Okay, what would you like? That coffee and toast? Would you like the sports page with that?
Jimmy?
Yeah, I'll be back.
wanted to catch you early so we could talk privately. I'm tweaking the menu, and I need to know how you feel about oyster stuffing.
I don't think I've ever tried it.
Well, in certain quarters, it's considered to be an aphrodisiac. And since we're going to be alone, I just wanted to be sure.
I'm sorry, alone?
Yes, just the two of us. And Kobe, of course. Oh, I briefly considered the big dinner thing, but with our hectic lives, I just never get to spend quality time with my gym boy.
True.
So the oyster stuffing's a go.
I'm afraid it's a no.
You prefer chestnut?
No, Cynthia, I'm sorry. It's a no on the stuffing and a no on the dinner. I can't go off and leave a rocket. I'm afraid my Thanksgiving is going to be a cold turkey sandwich down here in the clinic, and I know that's not what you...
I would love to.
You what?
Sounds positively primal. Just the two of us and Kobe and the... Jim? Oh, you're going to love my stuffing.
Hey, got a sec?
Yeah.
Rumor has it there was somebody around last night that looked like me, but acted a little unhinged.
It's okay, Johnny.
The thing that kills me is that I did everything right. Bert and I got tested. I'm on the pill.
Could you have missed one?
No, I've been, like, totally hyper. I don't know how this could happen.
Have you taken any medication in the last few months? Antibiotics?
I took some erythromycin, like, over a month ago. I had a few left from when I had bronchitis. I thought I was getting it again. Why?
Well, that's it. See, antibiotics can compromise the effectiveness of the pill.
Well, why didn't anybody tell me that?
Because you were self-medicating. Oh, Joni, there's always a chance that the test was wrong. We could repeat it.
The last time I felt like this, I was pregnant with Hannah. The last thing I wanted was for history to repeat itself.
All right, let's not get ahead of ourselves. There's always time to panic.
Yeah, well, the clock's ticking.
The guy at the music store told me that this is the best rental they had. What's the matter?
Needs new strings. I gotta borrow $10, all right?
No problem. Take it out of your advance. Here's 50. That was great, man.
That sure was, Mr. Ballard. You know, I saw him in Memphis at the Clover Club winter 98. You set that place on fire.
You did?
It's a real privilege to meet you, sir.
Thank you. I gotta get going. I gotta get these strings.
Sure.
Dr. Hansen?
Yes.
I'm Susan Fuller from the Rhode Island Institute of the Deaf.
Nice to meet you. Thanks for coming over.
My pleasure.
Let me take your coat.
But like I told you on the phone, I don't have any experience with primates.
Believe me, anything you can do will be helpful.
Where do you think he came from?
I suspect that he was either lost or stolen from one of the research facilities that specialize in animal communication.
Have you called around to check?
Unfortunately, there are hundreds of them all across the country, so if you could just give us some clue, something.
I'll do my best.
This is Heather.
Hi,
Ms. Fuller.
Nice to meet you.
And this is, well, he tells us his name is Rocket.
Well, let's see. Hello. My name is Susan. My name is Rocket. You were right.
Yeah.
This is what he keeps doing.
We translated it as, I feel sick.
You were pretty close, but you missed one sign. Home.
Home?
He's saying, I'm homesick.
Oh, my.
Is there any way you can get him to tell us where home is?
Where is your home?